To plant or to not to plant? That is the question many farmers are finalizing their answers to this summer. An excessively wet spring after a moisture-filled fall means several in Southeast Kelloland are not throwing in the seed. Instead, they're throwing in the towel this year. In tonight's Eye on Kelloland, Matt Holson visits a few operations south of Lennox, dealing with the aftermath of spring flooding.
That's a lot of mud. So much, Matt Lowy is spending money to dig out of it at his feedlot south of Lennox.
So I purchased this track loader to be able to get around in there, move some of the mud around, get it to dry, get the pen shaped, and eventually haul some out and that sort of thing.
The facility handles 1,000 head of cattle. Keeping them happy and hungry has been a chore, to say the least.
It's crazy. It's like a dog chasing its tail, you might say, or something. We just feel like we're crazy busy, and then when you get done with a day of work, it's like, I didn't get much accomplished.
Thanks to all the rain, Lowy's focus has been here, tending to the cattle that can use roughly 100,000 bushels of corn a year, most of which the farmer grows himself on 650 acres. Getting that seed in the ground this year, though, has been a challenge. Still, it's one he feels he needs to tackle.
Is it going to be more profitable for me to not plant the grain and buy it, or is it going to be maybe take a reduced yield and market it through the cattle, because buying the corn will come at a cost higher than typically I could sell it for at the elevator?
We visited his farm on a sunny day last week.
Matt Lowy was hoping to do some planting today, but he got caught in a rainstorm last night, and the field is still just a bit too wet for activity.
This work is taking place about 6 weeks later than normal. Many fields have been too wet in this area, forcing planting season to crawl along at a turtle's pace.
Finishing up planting some corn and got rained out about 7 o'clock last night, and I have just a few hours to plant to get done with that one. But again, you need to drive and check it, see if it's ready. You can't just wake up this morning and say, okay, now I have to go
we
plant.
We can get close here and look at the mud underneath.
A few miles away, Jonathan and Arlen Hagena just made the decision not to plant in several fields at all this year.
Everybody's in a little bit different situation, but there's a lot of people around here who've hung in the towel.
From the front porch, you can see one of the few fields of corn they were able to make happen. Jonathan says it's been one of the most difficult years in history for the farmers in this area, a place his family has lived for 100 years.
My grandparents grew up in the Depression, which was a time of unprecedented drought, so I'm sure they would be amazed at how much water we're getting right now. The result is the same, though. We're unable to grow a crop.
So you can see there's our home place over here. It was too wet on the north side to plant.
Driving around in his vintage 1977 Ford truck, you can see plot after plot unplanted. It's a sad sight to behold.
It's people's livelihood, and it's what we're passionate about and what we do for a living. So it's hard to see all these fields being unplanted.
Fortunately, the Hagena's decision to leave their seed on the shelf doesn't yield a devastating blow thanks to insurance.
This is 1 year. I'm in this for the long haul. We're fortunate that we do have prevent plant insurance coverage, which means that if we're unable to plant, we get some type of payment that it doesn't make us whole, but at least it allows us to survive another year.
Another reason to be positive, Jonathan says the family will get refunded for the seed they purchased 6 months ago that they won't use.
We invest in our farming operation, our equipment. We still have those bills to pay, and we'll be able to cover that and put shoes on the kids for another year and hope for a better year next year.
In the meantime, they plan to spend the summer improving drainage and finding a cover crop. Like the Hagenas, Lowy will also continue to take things one day at a time, depending on what Mother Nature throws his way.
I had to change a little of my plan around, but that's the story of this year, I guess. If you look at the calendar and time's against us, maybe I'm okay planting 85% of what I wanted to, and then worrying about that 15% later.
Every farmer's choices are different, but it sounds like the key is to have faith good things will sprout up eventually.
I would say keep your chin up, as farmers I think we're optimists because you put a seed in the ground and you trust that it's going to grow and something's going to come from it, and there's nothing we can do to make that happen.
With Eye on Kelloland, I'm Matt Holson.
The farmers say that they normally like to be done with planting by mid-May, which goes to show you how far behind many of them are. Now, even the most optimistic farmer can have down days, and it's important to talk to someone. Avera Behavioral Health has a free and confidential farmer stress hotline. That number is 1-800-691-4336.